of plasma chemical synthesis of tungsten carbon cobalt system nanopowders. Metal matrix composites with nanosize reinforcing particles attract great attention from researchers and developers due to the possibility of a significant increase in the functional and operational characteristics of the resulting materials and products based on them. Composite materials have extensive prospects of applications in various branches of industrial production, primary aerospace and defense industries. Currently, a significant interest in creation of metal matrix composites is also evident from the new intensity developing direction of innovative developments, additive technologies. Carried out experimental research aimed at developing the foundations for the formation of powder metal matrix tungsten carbon cobalt compound nanocomposites for use in additive technologies as a fundamental new development in the intensively developing direction of modern research. My talk will be about first step in producing of spherical nanocomposite powder, that is tungsten carbon cobalt nanopowder synthesis. Thermodynamic calculations of the equilibrium compositions of the Schön system have been performed to evaluate the influence of the concentration of precursors and the temperature of the process on the chemical and phase composition of the resulting tungsten carbon cobalt composition. It follows from the equilibrium compositions calculations that monocarbide with 100% yield can be obtained in the in considered system, but the maximum yield of tungsten monocarbide is achieved with significant excess of the reducing agent over the stoichiometrically necessary. The full conversion of tungsten into tungsten carbide can be achieved in the temperature range of 800 to 3700, depending on the excess of reducing agent and carbidizer. Cobalt was found to be present in the system as a condensing phase at temperatures below 2000 kelvins. Experimental studies on the nanopowder synthesis through the interaction of tungsten oxide and cobalt powders with methane in a nitrogen-hydrogen thermal plasma flow generated were carried out in a plasma setup based on an electric arc plasma torch with a nominal capacity of 25 kilowatts. Synthesis was carried out in a limited jet flow plasma reactor. The plasma-forming gas was heated in the plasma torch. The dispersed raw materials being transported by the gas into the plasma flow and the plasma torch outlet. After evaporation of the raw material and chemical reaction in the gas phase, the product particles were condensed and then deposited on the reactor water-cooled walls. Smallest fraction of the product was carried out in a filter with the exhaust gases. As a result of experimental research, nanopowders with a specific surface area of 20 to 25 square meters per gram were produced. Mean particle size of obtained nanopowders was about 50 nanometers. Overall carbon content in obtained nanopowders was in range from 5.5 to 6.5 weight persons. Oxygen content on obtained nanopowders was no more than 1 weight percent. Based on the results of X-ray phase analysis, the powders produced consist mainly of lower tungsten carbide and beta tungsten carbide phases with the traces of tungsten. There are no visible peaks of tungsten oxide phases on diffractograms. Cobalt peaks on diffractograms are also not noticeable due to the low intensity of peaks in the dominant phase's background due to the low content of cobalt in raw material. It has been established that when the excess of methane introduced to the process in relation to tungsten increased from 7.5 to 9.5 mol to mol, the total carbon content of the powders produced increased from 5.9 to 6.9 weight percent. The specific surface area increases slightly from 20 to 23 square meters per gram. According to X-ray phase analysis, powders produced with a higher carbidizer content contain more beta tungsten carbide phase. The presence of cobalt in obtained nanopowders was confirmed by X-ray fluorescence analysis. Also, it is worth noting, it is, by my opinion, one of our most important achievements, almost perfect distribution of cobalt over the volume of powder at the nanoscale. And I think that's all for today. Thank you for your attention.